So, answer to the question, is Affinity Photo worth the switch from Photoshop in 2020? What's up everybody, Rens here, back with yet another video. In today's video, I'll share my personal view and experience helping you decide whether it's worth it to switch from Photoshop to Affinity Photo in 2020. After uploading my last video, in which I show most Affinity Photo basics and essentials in just 15 minutes, which you can view right over here, many of you asked why I personally made the switch from Photoshop to Affinity Photo, so today I'm gonna answer that exact question. This video contains my personal opinion after intensively using Affinity Photo for 1 year for both personal and client work. It covers my experience with both photo editing softwares, including why I switched, features that I personally like in Affinity Photo, and features that I preferred in Photoshop. Let the battle begin. So I want to start off with my experience in both editing softwares. I've used Photoshop for about 3 years, and initially I wanted to do web design, but then I found out about photo manipulation. In these 3 years, I've used Photoshop CS6, Photoshop CC 2018, so I've never used the most recent versions. My main reason to switch to Affinity Photo was my decision to somehow monetize this photo manipulation skill, so I wanted to work in licensed software. Photoshop is amazing, but the pricing model made me look for alternatives. So I did some research, and Affinity Photo came out best. Here are the reasons why I personally switched to Affinity Photo. For serious users, Affinity Photo simply is a lot cheaper since it's a one-time purchase. You can buy it from affinity.serif.com for just $50 compared to Photoshop, which you pay a monthly subscription. Another great thing about Affinity Photo is that it looks very similar to Photoshop, so for me it was relatively easy to make the switch. I mean, look at the interface. It just looks very similar. Another great thing is that Affinity Photo can open Photoshop brushes. Also, Affinity Photo can save in .psd, which is Photoshop's file document, so others who aren't using Affinity Photo but Photoshop can also open the files. The interface of Affinity Photo is fully customizable, so you can completely customize it to your wants and needs. It's constantly improving and updating for free. I started in version 1.7.1, and 1 year later they are in 1.8.3, and the changes have been amazing. Another cool thing is that Affinity Photo offers a live preview when using brushes, blend modes, etc. So you can actually live see what you're doing before you've actually done it. There are also live filters and adjustment layers which have a built-in mask, so you can easily apply the adjustments to a certain part of the image. Also, in Photoshop you have to make use of smart objects, do not mess with the original pixels. In Affinity Photo this is not the case. Affinity Photo automatically resizes its layers in a non-destructive manner, so you can resize and rescale your pixel layers without actually messing the original pixels. The last thing that I want to mention, which is quite useful and handy when doing photo manipulation, which I love doing, is the built-in stock photos. From the built-in stock photos panel, you can simply search for any image on Unsplash, Pexels and Pixabay. Once the results are loaded, you can simply click and drag the photo onto your document to work with it. Now, as mentioned before, I've personally used Photoshop for 3 years, and here are some things that I loved about Photoshop over Affinity Photo. Photoshop is part of Adobe Suite, and this is including Photoshop, Illustrator, Lightroom, Adobe After Effects, Premiere Pro, etc., etc. This is an amazing package, however you do have to pay their monthly subscription to use all of the apps. Another thing that I really loved about Photoshop is their powerful camera raw filter. This is such a great tool to simply adjust some colors, to tweak it, to give it a nice little filter, etc. Affinity Photo has their developer persona, but in my opinion it's less developed than the camera raw filter of Photoshop. Since I do a lot of photo manipulation, I love transforming and reshaping objects. In Affinity Photo you have the mesh warp tool and the deform tool, and the deform tool is similar to the puppet warp tool in Photoshop. The deform tool works just a little different, and I think I personally like the puppet warp tool better because you can rotate your anchor points, which you cannot really do in Affinity Photo with the deform tool. And the last thing that I really loved about Photoshop, which is not available yet in Affinity Photo, I'm not sure if it will come, is Photoshop's video timeline to create animations and layer build-up videos. In Photoshop, it was really easy to create a nice animation or a layer build-up video from your artwork. So you can just show layer by layer and build it up until you have the nice end result. In Affinity Photo, this unfortunately is not possible. And after using Affinity Photo for 1 year, I found there is still some room for improvement for Affinity Photo. There are some things that are just still bugging. My Affinity Photo regularly crashes when moving selections in quick mask mode. Not many people know this is actually possible in Affinity Photo. However, when doing it, usually my Affinity Photo crashes. There are some workarounds, but this just doesn't work perfectly yet. Same thing for when rotating large brushes. When I use larger brushes in large document files, often Affinity Photo crashes when I start rotating my brushes. Also, with some things that I mentioned before already, like the lacking of the timeline and the pretty basic developer persona that Affinity Photo offers compared to the camera raw, and something I personally missed was the lack of photo manipulation tutorials and courses. So this is where I jumped in, and I'm actually considering creating a full photo manipulation course, and since it's a lot of work, it would be extremely useful for me to know beforehand if anybody of you would actually be interested in buying it. So let me know in the comments if you would be interested in following a full photo manipulation course where you learn from A to Z how to create amazing photo manipulations in Affinity Photo. So all in all, Affinity Photo is a great Photoshop alternative. After using Photoshop, it was fairly easy for me to switch to Affinity Photo. There's a lot of room for improvement, as I've mentioned before. However, I always find a workaround to get the same or similar results in Affinity Photo without it crashing. So, answer to the question, is Affinity Photo worth the switch from Photoshop in 2020? And my answer definitely is yes. One, because of their pricing model. And two, it's just an amazingly powerful photo editing software, just like Photoshop. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you found it useful in your decision making whether you should switch from Photoshop to Affinity Photo. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you like my content, feel very free to subscribe to my channel. And then I hope to see you in my next video. Peace!